Holy! Okay. That was brutal.
Hey guys, welcome back to Solemn Salmon's playthrough of Kingdoms of Amalur Reckoning, where we've just escaped from Alistar Tower and sadly lost Encel, the mighty moustached gnome. But we're out in the open air now, so we can do some exploring.
Level up.
Oh, this is going to take me a while to decide what we're going with.
Okay, so lots of choice. Hard to decide what exactly to put it in. We've already got two in stealth, which puts us over one of the milestones. We've got that persuasion, which is why I think we had such a high persuasion chance with Encel. Rest in peace, Encel. And Sagecraft we've got one in. So we could either throw it into stealth again, boost persuasion a little bit. Sagecraft, you can create powerful gems using lambent quality shards. I mean, maybe I'm thinking detect hidden might be a good one, because it's one of the milestone ones. Enemies and other characters displayed on the minimap can only be good. And we don't know enough about alchemy and bucksmithing to be doing any of that at this point. So yeah, I think detect hidden is a solid first point. Confirm. Oh, another tree. So three categories. Might, which, yeah, you're looking at weapons, big damage, probably long swords, things like that. Finesse, the more stealthy side of things, and sorcery, self-explanatory, it's magic. We've got 3 points available, so I think we're going to go for Shadow Flare, which seems to add another class of spell, perhaps, or to wound enemies in an arc, quickly press the button again. Yeah, I'm thinking. And then daggers, liking the daggers. And then we're going to throw one into Stormbolt, our only current available magic. So as you can see, it's keeping track of how many points we've spent in each category. So some powers, like the Mark of Flame here, requires 5 points of sorcery. So we're 3 away from that. That one's 35 points. So we're 32 points away from that. So a long time. But that is a level up. That has given us a bit more boost to our abilities. Oh, yeah, there is, look. Number two is our shadow. Is there someone over there messing with somebody's corpse? Because that's messed up. Hello. Oh, it's not a corpse. It's someone who's injured. Hey, is this Aura?
Thank Matharu. Another survivor. Are there any more?
She was one of the gnomes earlier.
I suppose that's a little bit of kindness from fate. May those still trapped inside rest peacefully. The well was a beautiful dream, an end to death, a cure to tragedy. It would have made war pointless. It could have saved the world. We should have known it was too good to exist. Now our friends have paid the price.
I do love how the Fateless One looks down at gnomes, because he's put his chin properly into his chest and he just looks like he's glowering down at them.
Who knows why the Tuatha hate mortals? Who knows why the Fae do half the things they do?
He's clearly having a good time in the background there. I'm so sorry.
Morris Hughes was one of the greatest minds of our generation. The Well of Souls was a dream that was almost too good to come true. This was supposed to be a nice isolated grove. So much for that. Stay safe. We'll be moving soon.
I'm really sorry, Praetorian. I wish I could help. I can't give you a health potion.
Good luck out there.
Thank you, and to you. Can I smash all this stuff up? Yes. Just turn my main. It's alright. I'm a guy that's thought I was assistant to. It's probably just like, what on earth? Is he's dead.
Oh, look, a deer thing.
There's like a red mark on the mini map in that direction. I'm guessing there's enemies over there. Up top, probably. Can I get in the water? I can get in the water.
Ah, more rats. And lots of boxes.
Let's try this out. Whoa. Hey, a skeleton.
Whoa, that is a glowing chest. Oh, lockpicking.
10% chance. Right, guess we're going to have to try and pick it. This sort of looks like pressing Alt D to move the slider. If the pick is at the correct angle, the lock will unlock.
It looks sort of like standard Fallout Bethesda Skyrim-y lockpicking, which I think has become quite usual. Okay.
Nope. Nope. Oh.
No. Almost.
Ooh.
Alright. Success! Oh! Shadow Prism, Cloudy Magic Shard. Let's try this one first before we go over to the. Easy. Good, good, good. I like very easy. Yeah, we'll try this one before we go over to the. Shadowy Chest. Ooh, that was clear the wrong direction. Okay! Dispel chest, easy. Dispel. For a minute there, I was genuinely like, what am I supposed to be doing? Press click. When the cursor is above a glyph to break it, glyphs will reseal themselves after a time. This can all the glyphs reseal. Okay. Some glyphs reseal faster than others. Be careful with the order you break them in. Break all the glyphs to dispel the ward. Okay. What? Oh my goodness. A good lesson in pain. But we did seem to unlock it. And ooh, green stuff. Scepters are long-range weapons preferred by mages. Each shot costs a small amount of mana. Okay. Let's put the... Let's call it a secondary. Smoldering Scepter. Nice. Alright, we're definitely going to take that then. And then primary, we'll put our daggers in. Oh, I forgot to look at the armor. Let's have a look at the armor. Sturdy Curious Possible. Oh man, that is hard to turn down. I know it looks weird. We're just going to have to go with it. Because it's good. It's like another RPG trope of wearing terrible armor just because you like how it looks. We're wearing the Fateless ones on the catwalk now. Showing off this summer's unusual style of having a full set of armor minus one thing which looks completely out of place. Oh, we'll have a look at that in a second. There's something going on down here. Is that a bear? Protect the random gnome. Oh, I messed up. That's me. Let's use that daggers. There we go. Nice. Hey! Come back here, bear! I'm not done with you yet. That'll teach that bloodthirsty berry eater. I don't really see how that's much of an insult.
You! I remember you!
Oh! Gorun! Oh no! Sign me off subject disposal detail. Gorun. If we meet Gorun, it's not going to end well. Spider guy!
You're the one? How did you come back? How did you find me here?
It was pure luck. If I'd known it was you, I'd have left you to the bear.
When I saw you with Ensel in the well, I ran. But it wasn't because I was afraid. I was coming to report that Hughes's experiment had succeeded.
Yes, which is why you ran outside.
The Well of Souls is bigger than just one gnome's pet project. My contact pays well for information about its progress.
Contact?
I just send reports to make some money on the side.
You're a traitor and a spider.
But I don't know how the Tawatha found out. This has nothing to do with them. I never wanted anyone to get hurt.
Is it possible that your contact was the Tawatha? Pay me and you live. Oh, this is tempting.
I promise you, if I knew who it was, I'd tell you. Sharing research is one thing, but academic sabotage is a crime.
So's murdering people, and so should be the spider thing. Well, I don't want to kill him. I'm not fundamentally a bad person, even though he has really annoyed me with the whole spider thing. And now it turns out with the whole it's kind of his fault thing. So let's try another persuasion check.
I don't have...
Success!
Okay. Here. It's all I've got. Plus what I got paid for the information.
You're a terrible person, Gurren.
I don't want any part of this. I'm going home to Odessa.
If we ever make it to Odessa, I'm going to find you. Probably do nothing. If I was going to do something, I'd have done it now. But you be sure, if we get to Odessa... Can you still hear me? I'm still... whatever. Glowy thing. No reagents found. Well, that's just typical. Okay, back to the Shrine of Mithura. Cool. Just assume that that's good. Are those wolves? Hey, dear thing. Rat wolves. Oh, it's like... For a minute there, that was pretty badass. I'm being wrecked by these wolves. This has gone poorly. Should not have taken on the wolves. Ah, R is the quick potion one. Oh dear. Oh dear. We're getting wrecked by wolves. Oh, now that's the ticket. Two down. We're getting somewhere. You know, wolves are actually my favourite animal, so getting wrecked by four of them and then wrecking four of them was not ideal, I'm going to be honest. But treasure. 13 gold. I don't know if that's really enough for what we went through.
You've come from the tower, haven't you? Name's Agar.
Ah, it's the guy we were looking for.
Maybe you can help an old Fate Weaver, eh?
Fate Weavers look at the great tapestry of fate. The threads will tell us how a life will unfold. But knowing the future and being able to change it are two very different things.
All right. Hughes sent me to find you.
Did he? Poor old Fomarus Hughes. He respected the way the world works. What a shame. He's probably dead by now.
Now that is positive.
The cards told me that the Well of Souls would work, but Hughes's success would come on the day of his death.
Oh.
He took it pretty well, honestly. Although we did a lot of drinking after that.
Oh, boy.
You really don't know much, do you?
No.
A fate weaver taps into the threads of fate and channels that energy through a focus. My order prefers cards. The cards are unique to each fate weaver, since we all see the weave differently.
All right, let's go for another persuasion check. Solid 95%.
I suppose I could spare a little help in memory of Hughes, or in celebration of his success. Whichever.
Oh, yes. Okay. Solid, I just woke up, or that's okay, I was dead.
Oh, boy.
Let's go with I just woke up.
You? You're the one?
I don't think it really would have mattered.
Then that means it all makes sense now. The cards this morning. I drew the Gravedigger, the Running Man, and the Beast. Prepare yourself. They're coming.
Oh, back to combat. Oh, yeah, actually combat.
Another dustling for the fire.
Your future is running out!
Oh my goodness, he's actually helping. He's so much more helpful than Ensel. Okay.
Well fought.
Thank you. You fought well as well. Oh my goodness. Different types of enemies.
God,
that didn't help.
Sacrifice.
The camera was facing the wrong direction. When your faint meter is full, the fate symbol will pulse. You can then use your fate energy to enter reckoning mode. Reckoning mode greatly increases your speed and attack power. It lasts either until your fate meter runs out or you fate shift an enemy. Hold X to harness the power of fate and enter reckoning mode. Holding X.
Your life is mine!
Do I have to keep holding it now? Move near an unraveling enemy and press F to perform a fate shift. This uses your remaining fate energy to destroy an unraveling foe and grants you an experience bonus. Holy! Okay. That was brutal.
What? How? What are you? The threads of fate. I've seen them before, but I've never seen anyone manipulate them like that.
I'm special.
You just changed how the world was supposed to work. How did you do that?
Well, first of all, I held the X button.
You just... Fate is the will of the gods. No mortal should be able to change it. How is that even possible? Come here. I'm going to do a reading. You might be able to change the threads, but fate will still have a plan for you. I promise not to tell you if I see your death. It's a gift. Some people paint landscapes. Other people write poetry. I peer into the weave of fate's tapestry and see people's deaths. That would be my guess. He was an academic, but he had a proper respect for fate's plan, unlike most gnomes.
That's gnome racist.
You're nervous. Relax. This is what fate weavers do. I'll be seeing your place in the pattern of destiny. Who you are, what you've done, where your path takes you. Or, at least, I should be. You're real, right? I swear, I haven't had that much... I am. But still, I've never seen someone whose fate was just missing. Not even when I was drunk as the King of Ballads.
I like this guy.
This doesn't make sense. All mortal creatures have a place in the pattern. You should have one too, dead or not. If this is true, And I'm not saying I believe it. Then your path is yours to determine.
You know, I think there's a reason that they call us the the Fateless One. Acolyte, magic, brawler, straight up stabby,
rogue,
liking the rogue. Probably going to go with that. Let's check him out, though. Must be the element forces. Oh, and then I see, so the more you get... Oh, so you can combine. I like that. So maybe we can get finesse sorcery combined, both the magic and the... Nice. Let's take rogue. Confirm.
I can see the threads around you, but they're shifting, changing so rapidly, I can't make sense of them. Normally the threads would guide my hand to the cards, and I'd use those cards to see your pattern in the weave.
His mouth just stopped moving.
But it just didn't happen. They wouldn't focus. So either there's something wrong with me, and there isn't, or there's something very wrong with you.
Well, that's just rude. I didn't come here to be insulted.
It could mean nothing. Or it could mean everything. The world is changing. You might be a sign of that. Or maybe the cause. I've never had a reason to doubt my own readings. But we should consult with Arden. He's not a friend, but he's got a good eye for the tapestry. I'll meet you at his home to the east. I'm going to see if I can be of any help to the wounded at the tower. You can find Arden's little cottage in the middle of Yovan. Had to move there when he got run out of town.
Oh, he already sounds like a great guy.
He's a damned good fate weaver. But that doesn't make you very popular. Especially not in dark days like these. That's just it. I don't know if you've got one. But that's why we're going to see Arden. He lives in a little hut to the east in Yulven. I'll meet you there. What could this all mean?
That was dramatic. I think that was a DLC quest that just popped in there. Yeah, and there's the other one.
Of all the songs in halls of lore, there echoes none more grand than Olain's many feats of might, the pure and lady of the light. She is a knight of golden nut. She is the cure seeker, the conscience of the summer fay. She is the heart of spring, of day.
Who said that? Hi. You from around here? What the hell is that? The other way, goose. Oh, well, this is nice. Uh-oh. I see a mob. A pogrom. There's another cow thing.
Everyone, just stand back. The warden can't work when you're crowding so close. Go back to your business. Go on.
Can you believe those monks?
Hello.
You picked the wrong...
Keep moving. This business doesn't concern you. Unless you're an expert scholar on the Fae, I'd suggest you move along. No reason to be out in the open with the Red Legion about.
Now, these Red Legion you mentioned.
Bandits, but no ordinary bandits. Surely you've heard of Red the Dead Idward. They say he drinks the blood of his captives, that he consumes their souls.
Oh.
Or perhaps those are just rumors. You should be fine if you stay inside the village. Once you go beyond the boundaries of Gorhart, however, your life is in your hands.
Well, you know, I was recently dead, so I don't know how true that is.
I don't know if you noticed, but St. Ordwig's mission closed its gate moments before that Fae's body turned up on the road. I don't like what that suggests. Not at all.
I sent a quest.
The brothers of St. Odwig's are an odd sort, scurrying back and forth across the mission like squirrels gathering nuts. I wonder what goes on behind those closed doors.
No.
Oh.
Could you stop moaning? It's really ruining my dialogue with, Eowyn. Hello, Herrick. Oh, he's got a question mark.
I don't care what you race.
Got a question mark, exclamation mark.
It's a tragedy whenever anyone's savaged like this. Just look at the poor creature. She's been beaten to the brink of death. The Fae may be strange, but they certainly don't deserve this. It appears she was attacked with some manner of short blade.
Uh-oh.
Likely a dagger.
It was not
no
me.
Way I can be sure.
I was too dead to do
People
it.
People simply stood by as she called for help. No one lifted a finger. Can you imagine? It's shameful to treat another in such a way, even if she is a fae.
That's sort of
I
fae
don't
racist.
Know whether we possess the knowledge to treat such a wound. Frankly, I don't even know if I could save a mortal with such grievous wounds.
Thumbs up. I'd like to help.
Well, you're the only one.
Quest!
With all the troubles we've suffered in this village, people are weary of adversity. They'd rather just ignore it. I'm going to suggest something a bit... untraditional.
Please go on.
There's a fae named Eri. She spends her days up on the hill overlooking the village. Seek her wisdom. I would do it, but... I'm a coward. That's the truth. Perhaps a fae will know how to heal a fae. If not, then we're back where we started.
You got all that armor, all that big sword, and you're a coward.
She spends her days on the precipice overlooking the village.
Brave to admit it, though.
She doesn't think we're aware of her presence, but we most certainly are.
So she's crap at stealth.
Bye now.
Right, let's heal her so that the moaning stops. And we can all get on with our days. And then we'll find a shop. Sell all
Cast down the brothers of St. Odwig's. Only when they fall to earth will they realize they are not above us. The bricks of St. Odwig's were laid upon a foundation of exclusion and hate. How else do you explain their fear?
Ooh,
they know the walls will topple.
I'm just going to back off here. Do you know what she's on about?
Did you hear that Nanny's apprentice calf disappeared?
I'll take that as
just
a no.
Just another strange occurrence.
Hello.
Whatever you do, avoid the monks of St. Odwig's Perpetual. They deal in lies and false tenets. The light of hope will leave you in shadow. It is the name I chose when I baptized myself in the clear waters of Metharu. I have undergone the ordination rites and am as legitimate as any monk.
Okay.
You don't know. It is less a mission than a fortress of deception, a citadel of lies. It throws its menacing shadow over all of Gorhart. Father Dinwell will try to defend his cause, but he is simply a soldier, marching to the orders passed down to him. None of them have minds of their own.
This seems suitably religiously political that I'm hesitant to get involved.
He would be a good man if he could see past the rigidity of his faith. Mitharu embraces all, not simply those that the church deems worthy.
Uh-huh. And do you know anything about the wounded
She was wronged by someone in this village. That is an injustice I can understand. By its appearance, you'd assume Gorhart is a pleasant place.
It is pretty.
Never make assumptions.
Okay.
Just... Greetings.
Yes, we were just talking. You and me. We were literally just talking. Also, there's an arrow over the top of that chest. Loot. Special deliveries chest. Looting. Oh! Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Oh, hello DLC stuff. Take all. You have reached the limits of your character's inventory. Well. Oh, I'm one off. Well, this changes the order of our intended quests. I've literally just got everything. Yep. Those look pretty cool. Add to junk. Fae blades. Well, we've improved our daggers at the moment, so... okay. Look at the difference in damage. That's 41 to 17. You're getting a really good look at what you get for DLC at the moment. In other words, lots of things. Right, we have now boosted... Oh, am I wearing trousers? No. There we go. Now we are dressed up in all of the fancy DLC stuff. Yeah, let's go sell everything we've just added. Wow, I look evil now. Like, properly evil. Right, I'm just going to change the settings so that it removes the helmet. But there is the helmet. Proper evil to start with. There we go. Yeah, I think it looks better without a helmet. But we'll still get the bonuses from it. I've just removed it from view. Not actually removed.
Welcome.
Hello. Corner shop. Perfect. Hello, sir. I would like... No, you're just a citizen. Oh, glowy. Oh, yeah. We,
Greetings.
God. Ah! Nettie.
Are you here for a weapon? Going to earn a lord's favour in this ridiculous war, are you?
No. What I would like to do is sell everything, which you don't seem to do. You seem to do repairing. So goodbye.
I'll be here.
You were the wrong person. Aha!
Hello.
Ricka.
Welcome to Gorhart.
Yes, hello.
The last settlement before the Feylands. How can I fill your pack today?
It's more about emptying my pack, I'm going to be honest. Sell all junk. Money! Wow, that's significantly reduced the amount of stuff we have. Yeah, I've largely kept the, do you want a skull? Apparently she does. How about some tattered documents? Ah, thank you.
Goodbye.
You were the helpful one, Ricka. I'll remember you.
Enough of
yeah,
the oppression.
Yeah, all right, we get it.
Enough of the lies.
Oh.
Enough of the spiritual hoarding and claims of superiority.
Is this the guy she was
Mithorin
talking about earlier?
Does not
Hello,
judge.
Question mark.
She loves.
Welcome to St. Odwig's perpetual mission. I would invite you in, but the Order has been too trusting in the past. We try to learn from our mistakes. Although, one never knows what might be a test of faith. You have arrived just when I am in need of aid.
Really?
So perhaps Mitharu is at work.
How can I help you?
We at St. Odwig's have worked for years to establish a presence on this hill. It's not been without its challenges. The call of the Feylands does not fall upon deaf ears, and many of our youngest don't have the will to resist. Take Brother Egan, for example. Two nights ago, Egan ventured past the walls to collect firewood and never returned.
Oh dear.
We must find him before anything happens.
That sounds like a quest for the Fateless One.
Mitharu be praised. His order reigns supreme.
Also
Brother Egan was last seen northeast of here, just off the road near the Fey Ruins. Please find him. Perhaps then we can welcome you into the fold with open arms.
What is the mission hiding? Why are its gates forever
closed? Why are they forever closed?
These are the questions we all should be asking.
Yes.
Insist that St. Odwig's admit monks of all sexes and races into its ranks.
Equality.
Or tell them to peddle their poison elsewhere.
Yeah. And onward. Right, let's go do some questing. Oh, red dot on the map. Enemy. What's it going to be? What's it going to be? Ooh. What is it going to be? I'm not here, it's on me. Bogart. Oh, there are lots of red dots on the map now. Glowy underneath them all, so that's pretty cool. Resisted, still blew up.
Ooh.
That direction would seem to take me to the Fae's house. Ah, we're nearly at Brother... Brother missing. Brother Mysterio. Brother, he's disappeared. Oh, Brother, he's fighting a boggart. You went missing for 2 days. How are you... What have you been doing? Don't put your sword away. Hey! Hey! Brother Egan. Hi. Where you been? What you been doing?
Yes? What could a mortal vagabond need with Kazmaran, the Eternal, messenger of the Fae Folk? Speak! My time may be of the ages, but it is still precious. I'm new to the Feylands. Until I joined the mission, I'd never even left my home village. That's why I volunteered. I wanted to see the world. I want to visit the gardens of Issa, to meet gnomes and Alfar, to live. The Order of Mitharu was a good way to leave home, but I want so much more.
Well,
It sounds rather silly, doesn't it?
Yes, it does.
I had a feeling it would.
And my name's Solemn Salmon, so
I need
know.
A mage name for when I become all-powerful, for when my magic is so great that no one will dare dispute me. What about Abner the Visionary, or Malik the Nefarious, Lord Zaltanus? No? And those were the good ones.
Abner the Visionary, I quite liked that one.
Wait, Father Dinwell sent you, didn't he? Old fool. His path to power was too plodding, and now he wishes to slow me down too. I have new friends, Fae friends. They are named Finna and Arbos, and they have sworn to share their secrets with me and to gift me with true magic.
This seems like a scam.
In exchange, they want an ancient treasure buried in the caverns of Waterhall Down. I'll retrieve it, eventually, as soon as I, feel like it.
This seems like a scam.
They are Fae twins, and they are beautiful, magical creatures. They've promised to teach me magic. To help me see the world as it really is.
100% this is a scam.
All they require of me is to fetch for them this relic. It's quite a bargain, believe me. Fine, if you want to be so noble, but don't expect any of the treasure. This is my key into a powerful new future. A future full of magic and wonders. Let's go.
What, right now?
It is okay. In the caves of Waterhall Down. A refuge for the wild fae. They believe I have the potential to succeed where all others have failed, including them.
Are they just sending idiots
to do
this? You see,
they can't obtain what they desire, so they need someone more powerful to do it.
Uh-huh.
Then they will bestow upon me the wisdom of the Fae.
You're an idiot.
It is called the Selkie Veil, and it's said to possess the power to transform its wearer into any form he wishes. Finna says it belongs to the Fae, but was stolen.
You're an idiot.
Bye then.
What? Oh, fine. Moron. Let's go do this stupid quest. That's a lot of red dots over there. Oh, he's actually doing damage.
See some Fae.
Yeah, well, maybe we'll see someone with some common sense. Hey guys, thanks for watching this video. Make sure to check out some of the other videos on this channel if you enjoyed it, and please like and subscribe for more. Until next time.